What's good? It's Woog. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's talk music. The popular FYF Music Festival was recently canceled, and while Golden Voice's official statement isn't even really worth stating, Billboard reports that it was due to low ticket sales. Now, LA Times writer Michael Wood, or Mikhail Wood, pardon the pronunciation, just released an article about how this cancellation is a discouraging setback for women's progress in music, since the lineup was headlined by female artists Janet Jackson and Florence and the Machine. But when you really break it down, this didn't sell poorly because the public isn't ready to embrace women artists as festival headliners, see Beyonce. This festival failed because that lineup wasn't worth festival ticket prices to its target audience. Let's break this down. Compare 2018's lineup to 2016's, just the headliners. In 2016, the four biggest names were Kendrick Lamar and Tame Impala on Saturday, and LCD Sound System and Grace Jones on Sunday. In 2018, the top four were Florence and the Machine and Future on Saturday, and Janet Jackson and The XX on Sunday. So who is the target audience? Well, young adults. Grown folks generally aren't trying to stand around all day long in the dead of summer to party with the youngins. Usually, if they want to see someone in concert, they'll go to their show. They aren't as thrilled by the thought of 50 artists in one day. So 2016, Kendrick Lamar is one of the greatest artists of the generation. He might be the very best in critical acclaim and also does well commercially. He's Kendrick Lamar, backed by Aftermath Interscope. He's one of the two biggest rappers in the game and has been for a few years now. Tame Impala, one of the hippest indie bands out. Kevin Parker has become one of music's go-to musician producers. They don't have number one pop hits or anything, but all three of their albums, Interspeaker, Lonerism, and Currents, are critically acclaimed, and people have discussions on which of their albums is best and why. They're like the modern Pink Floyd. Plus, Tame Impala doesn't play that often in the US, so this was a rare chance to see them in concert. LCD Sound System is another one of the hippest groups, and their legend grew even larger when they retired for a few years recently, until the masses demanded their return, which they eventually got. But on this 2016 bill, they were still retired, and this was one of their only shows before eventually dropping a new album in 2017. So the demand for LCD Sound System was super high at the time of this festival. Grace Jones is a 70s and 80s music and cultural icon, fashion icon, style icon, and this particular era has a deep appreciation for David Bowie-like style trailblazers. There's also a renewed interest in new wave music and art pop. She wasn't a huge commercial success, but many artists make a much bigger impact than their Billboard chart performance would indicate. Grace Jones is one of them. Interesting selection. I was surprised to see her on the bill, actually. Now fast forward 2 years to 2018. Florence and the Machine. She's a really big artist. She's pretty current, though her two biggest hits in the US were about 10 years ago and 7 years ago. Those being The Dog Days Are Over and Shake It Out from 2008 and 2011. Also, Florence and the Machine is a much bigger artist overseas than she is in the States. She charts better in the UK, Australia, Austria, Belgium, Ireland, Germany, Switzerland, and New Zealand than she does in the US. Not that she isn't big here, she does have a lot of fans, but she isn't a household name in the US like she is abroad, and her biggest commercial success, as mentioned, was almost a decade ago. American music fans often have short memories. Her fan base is now largely 30 and up. Again, not the biggest festival goers. Future is hot. A lot of commercial success. If I had to rank him among today's rappers, I'd say he's top 6 to 8 in current popularity, maybe even top 5. He's got 4 consecutive number 1 albums. I do think that this run that he's on will be wrapping up pretty soon, mainly because of his musical style. He's been around since 2010 and super hot since 2014. That already exceeds most hot rapper shelf lives. And to be honest, rappers usually don't retain fan loyalty over time in the same way that rock artists and country artists do. But that's a different discussion for another day. Janet Jackson. This was supposed to be the showstopper, but it might have been the biggest miscalculation of all. Janet Jackson killed it through the 80s, stayed hot through the 90s, successful albums, a bunch of hits, then finally fell off after her All For You album in 2001. That's more than a 2-decade run. Phenomenal. Now, that end of the run was still 17 years ago, and most of her biggest hits were 20 to 35 years ago. So how many people are going to pay a couple $100s or more so they could go to an all-day festival to sing along and dance to Control, Nasty, and Let's Wait a While from 86? Rhythm Nation and Escapade from 89 and 90, or even That's the Way Love Goes, Again and Anytime, Any Place from 93 and 94, they'll pay to see her at Staples Center, The Forum, Hollywood Bowl, not necessarily at a festival. Most Janet Jackson fans, quite frankly, just don't have the knees or the backs for this anymore. The kids do, but what do most of today's festival goers really know about Janet Jackson, and how badly do they want to see her? Then, the XX. Come on, I like them. I've bought their albums. They're a cool, smooth, nocturnal sounding band, not a festival headliner. Although I never have seen them play at night, which is probably the best time to experience the XX, but regardless, they're indie popular. They ain't that damn big, even if their last album hit number 2 in the US. And, like Florence and the Machine, the XX is also bigger in the UK, Australia, Belgium, Germany, Canada, Switzerland, New Zealand than they are in the US. FYF was trying to sell these tickets during and after Coachella. I just don't think that there was enough of an appetite for the headliners. I like the rest of the lineup too, but I'm a music enthusiast. I love US Girls, Car Seat Headrest, The Internet, Daniel Caesar, St. Vincent, and Destroyer. But the prices they're pushing for these multiple day festivals, in this case, backfired. Let me know what you think of the cancellation and of the lineups. Be sure to check out that article by Michael or Mikhail Wood for the LA Times. The link is in the description of this video. I get the argument that he's making because on the surface, you do see two big female stars headlining a show that ultimately failed. But under further review, I think that a lack of some key details played a larger role in the cancellation. We could even have some fun in suggesting some names of other female artists who would have probably been a stronger sell to festival goers. Hell, Missy Elliott and Bjork were two of the headliners at FYF's 3-day event in 2017. But let me know your thoughts. I'm Woog. Thanks for tuning in.